Assalamu alaikum dear students, hope you all are doing good. I am your science teacher of grade 5. Students, open your book, page number 6. In previous class, we were started topic vertebrates. Vertebrates are animals which have a backbone. We were also discussed the characteristic of fish. Today, our topic is amphibians. Amphibians are actually those animals which live on land as well as in water. For example, take an example of frog. Frog live on land as well as in water. An amphibian is a vertebrate that spends part of its life in water and parts of its life on land. Now, amphibians are those animals, those vertebrates which spend part of life in water and part of life on land. When amphibians are young, they live in the water and breathe through gills, just like a fish. When amphibians are young, they live in water and they breathe through gills. Gills are actually small holes present on skin of their body, just like fish. Fish also breathe through gills. So, example of fish. Fish also breathe through gills. Just like fish, they can also breathe through gills. As they grow older, they develop lungs to survive on land. As they grow, the amphibians grow, they develop lungs. Lungs can also help in breathing. They develop lungs to survive on land, to live on land. Most amphibians have smooth skin, but some toads are covered with warts, a thick, slimy substance called mucus. Protect the skin. Now, most amphibians have a smooth skin. The thick, slimy substance is called mucus. Underline this definition. The thick liquid that produce in the body parts that protect the skin is called mucus and helps to keep it moist. Amphibian eggs are called spawn. Now, amphibians lay eggs. These eggs are called spawn. They are soft because they have no shell. The amphibians' eggs are soft. Why? Because they have no shell. Shell is the outer layer. Remember and understand, what is spawn? As I told you, amphibians' eggs are called spawn. As well as you can also say that egg mass of amphibians and fishes are called spawn. Look at this diagram. First one is moist skin. Now, what is the function of moist skin? Moist skin also used for gas exchange. It can help for gas exchange. Nostrils leading to lungs, which are used for gas exchange. It's a nostril which also helps in gas exchange. Wide mouth. As adult amphibians are all carnivores. Carnivores, what do you mean by carnivores? Carnivores are actually flesh-eating animals. Herbivores are plants-eating animals. Carnivores are flesh-eating animals. Now, this wide mouth helps in to eat carnivores. And adult amphibians are all carnivores. They can eat insects. Four limbs with hind limbs webbed for hopping and swimming. Now, these four limbs help in hopping, also helps in swimming. Come to the next page, page number 7. Reptiles. Now, we are going to study the characteristic of reptiles. Lizards, snake, crocodiles, alligator, turtles and tortoise are all reptiles. These are examples of reptiles. Underline this line. They have dry scaly skin and breathe through lungs. What is the characteristic of reptile? They have dry scaly skin. They have dry skin and scaly. and breathe through lungs. They use lungs for breathing. Look at this diagram. Crocodile, their skin are dry and scaly. Look at this turtle, their skin is dry. They lay eggs on land. The eggs of some reptiles have leathery shell, while others are hard like bird's egg. Now they lay eggs on land. When they lay eggs on land, some eggs are leathery shell. Some eggs have leathery shell. Their shells, their outer layer is just like leather, while other are hard like bird's egg. Other eggs are hard. Just an example of bird's egg. They are just like it. It's enough for today. Thank you, student. Have a nice day.